What's up, guys? It's Brandon here again for another video. Now, in today's video, I'm going to be talking about some of the dark sides of this the journey for spiritual enlightenment. And I had been basically learning about spiritual enlightenment for roughly 3 years now. And in that journey, I have come to many different realizations. There were many different points where I felt like I had, you know, reached a breakthrough. And that's really something to be expected with enlightenment, because there are so many levels to this, just so many different levels that, you know, you're gonna reach points where you feel like you've got the answer. And now the more that I learn about it, the more that I just see, like, for one, there is no one answer. I mean, there kind of is, if we're talking about non-duality. You can become directly conscious of what non-duality is. And when you do that, yeah, there are in some ways some just simple answers about this life here on planet Earth that you get into. But for me, one thing that's been so tricky about this enlightenment journey that I've been on is that I was diagnosed with bipolar disorder type 1 about 6 years ago. And having a mental health diagnosis and seeking enlightenment, they in a way kind of go hand in hand. And the one way that it goes hand in hand is that you're going to come to a point where in a certain mental health diagnosis, you might seek for some type of transcendence of suffering. And that was really one of my main interests in enlightenment. I came to it because I've always been pretty interested in the pursuit of truth and seeking truth, wanting to know deep philosophical answers. I think really pretty much everyone as a child experiences that desire to some extent, but culture is just going to tear that down, tear down your innate desire to have those answers, you know, piece by piece. But having a mental health diagnosis, I mean, I came to this journey wanting to transcend my suffering. In Buddhism, there's the common kind of adage or term that people use, life is suffering. And a lot of people in the United States or other Western countries might really misunderstand what the Buddhists actually mean, which is that the egoic life that you are living right now, where you think that you're a separate self, that is suffering. And pretty much every religion that you come to, it's going to have the idea of suffering or some type of problem, and then it's always going to have a solution. Now, I've dabbled a lot in Eastern philosophy over these past 3 years, learning about spiritual enlightenment. Eastern religious philosophy, Buddhism, Hinduism, and then some of the other kind of more secular spirituality. It sounds weird to say, but it kind of is. The more secular spirituality that is becoming really popular online and in the Western world right now. And a lot of that's focused around meditation, which, to be honest, is one of the best ways to kind of come to really directly experiencing a lot of these things that people talk about in these Eastern philosophies when they're talking about enlightenment. And, you know, this is just something that you can experience yourself. And, you know, I've talked before about how I've been interested in the YouTube channel actualize.org, and now there's a dog barking at me. you know, a small sliver of what you might say is, life is suffering. There's a dog barking at me. I don't want the dog to bark at me. Why do I not want the dog to bark at me? Because I'm making a video. Because I'm a limited form in this world. That's the idea, at least. I'm Brandon Rowe. And Brandon Rowe is trying to make a YouTube video. So anyway, why I'm talking about all this is because about 2 weeks ago, I had some direct experiences of non-dual truth brought about through a bit of an obsession with meditation. And I say obsession because that's really what it was. I began really trying to get spiritually focused, meditate, to, you know, find out these truths with enlightenment and transcend suffering. And what I've realized is that you can overdo it. And that's what I did. And, like I mentioned before, being diagnosed with bipolar disorder type 1, there are many different traumas and problems and, kind of things that are lacking in my own psychology and in my own life, to where, you know, if a Buddhist monk who's been practicing meditation and basically kind of turned off his what you know, the normal person in a Western world would say, like, their worldly desires for food, sex, and shopping and all that stuff, if a Buddhist monk has come to the point where they're very successful at kind of getting away from that worldly life, when they have a direct conscious experience of non-dual truth or enlightenment, when they have that, it is a much different beast than when someone like me has a direct experience of that. Because when I have an experience of something like that, and I did, and many Buddhists or Hindu people or people of all faiths, all religions, have experienced these type of awakenings, spiritual awakenings, when you experience this, it's going to change your life. And for me, it changed my life a bit too fast. I began donating money. I began you know, just living in the now. And it's funny, there was a similar theme with this last year. And I had spiritual awakenings that later turned into manic episodes. And the same thing happened this year. And I found out that, you know, especially if you have a mental health diagnosis, you're really going to want to be balanced with how you practice spirituality and this pursuit of enlightenment. If you're too imbalanced, if you really try to do too much at once, it can completely trash your everyday life. At this point in time, it's unclear if there's going to be some problems with my employer, my main employer. I have two jobs and my own business, but it's unclear if because of some of the postings I did while I was in that state, and then later in my manic episode, it's unclear if they might not want to keep me working there, or something might change with my employment because of that. And, you know, of course, I said I was donating money, and, you know, frivolous spending is something that's very common in manic episodes. But for me, the more that my episodes have come or really been triggered by spiritual awakenings and understanding, the more that my spending has been less towards me and more towards others. And this makes sense. If non-duality is the truth, you're going to realize that the limited self that you've been so attached to, like for me, this Brandon Rowe, you're going to realize that on some levels, it isn't as true as you thought it was. And when you realize that, you're going to change. and you're not going to have as much kind of as much of a need to maintain this Brandon Rowe ideology or whatever your name is or whatever your identity is. You're not going to work as hard to maintain that. And for me, you know, like I said, with bipolar disorder type 1, a lot of different traumas and things in my past kind of build me up to where my psychology has some very dark problems that need to be worked through. And every time that I have an awakening experience, and also any type of manic episode, it has an interesting way of working through these traumas. But yeah, the main reason I'm making this video is I just want to say, like, if you're on the path to try to find truth, and it takes you down a spiritual road, spirituality is ultimately the more fundamental truth that there is here on our planet Earth. That's just the case. But knowing that that's true, you might become far too focused on that journey to try to find the truth, the infinite love, the bliss, what in the Hindu faith is known as Sat Chit Ananda, existence, consciousness, bliss, the nature of Brahman, or one notion that they use to define God. When you're on a journey to understand these beautiful principles and really become directly conscious of them, just be aware that it has the potential to harm your everyday life. And when something has the potential to harm your everyday life, you do need to proceed with some caution. And I would say, as you start to go on this journey, if this is something you're on, moderation is key. You don't want to make a quick change from not meditating every day to meditating every day. That could be a negative thing, because it could very well trigger in you a legitimate spiritual awakening. But a legitimate spiritual awakening in someone whose life is not very well aligned with what that awakening will show you, it can create problems. So that pretty much covers a lot of what I wanted to hear. Enlightenment is 100% real. Like, it's the most fundamental truth that there is to this existence. Or as far as we know, I would say any existence. It's literally the understanding of truth from an epistemologically sound basis, which basically means the basis of human knowledge. How can you best know what is true? And that's what enlightenment is. You're going down a journey, a path, to experience the truth, to become directly conscious of the truth, to where you'll know it's true. Now the words that you use to describe the truth or to describe what's happening to you, those might be false, those might be delusional, but you will feel the truth, and it's there. And there are many different methods to do this. But just be careful. When you feel infinite love, beauty, and you come into a bit of oneness with the amazing nature of this creation here that we're living in, just be ready. There might be some bumps along the road. And if you have a mental health diagnosis, proceed with extra caution. But other than that, I'm going to get off here. I hope you guys enjoyed the video and got something positive out of it. If you have any questions about the video or the content that I've talked about here, go ahead and ask them in the comment section, and I'll try to answer them. So thanks for watching. Bye.